My dear students, this is Saloni Jain, your host. Welcome to my YouTube channel, Learn Programming in Saloni. In our previous video, we have discussed what is Excel, what are the features of Excel, what can Excel do, and what are the basic components of Excel screen. Okay, now in this video, we will discuss how to enter the data in an Excel worksheet. Okay, how can you enter numbers, entering formula, entering text, okay, entering numbers as text, okay, and entering date and time. So first of all, whenever you type numbers, it generally types and press the enter key. Okay, so whenever you type the number, by default it is right line. See, it is right line. And whenever you enter the text, suppose I'm writing the name. See, so these are the names. By default, these are the left line. Okay, these are the left line. Numbers are always right line, and text is always left line. Okay, and whenever you want to type formula. Suppose I just type here the heading, roll number, okay, name. Suppose I just enter here the subject name, English, Maths, Science, Hindi, and Social Science. Okay, now you see, whenever I click here, the Social Science, half letters will move to the next cell. So for this, either you just drag it like this, or if you don't want to reduce this, increase the cell size, just click here, wrap text. So automatically it will wrap to the second line. Okay, and type here total and then percentage. Okay, percentage. Okay, now you know how to enter numbers and you know how to enter text. So if you want to text as a number, sorry, numbers as a text, so just press apostrophe sign and press the number. See, and it will show you the error also. This is a symbol of error. If this number is, this cell is formatted as text, okay, because it is preceded by apostrophe. So if you want any number like this, suppose I just type here the apostrophe, okay, like this. Now if you want to calculate the sum using the auto sum, it will show you one because it is a right line. Okay, and it will change the whole range. So select the range, this range only, okay, and click on the cell. It will show you the zero because these cells are left aligned. Type again, okay, or just remove the apostrophe sign. Okay, you can remove the apostrophe sign by using the F2 function key for by editing. Okay, see, now the sum is calculated, the auto sum calculated the formula. Now if I put absent here, it will reduce the number of signs. But if you use the manual formula, suppose I just put the number, I just put a formula. Formula always start with equal sign, this sign, this is a cell. You cannot use values directly. Okay, now you enter the values in the cells. Okay, now use the cell reference. This is C and this is 2. So my cell reference is C2 plus D2 plus E2 plus F2. Plus G2 and just press the enter. So it will show you the formula, the sum of the of these numbers. Okay. Now if I put absent here, it will show you the error. So this is not a reliable formula for this because whenever I use absent mark, it will show you the error, dash hash value error. Okay. So if you use again the sum auto sum function, is placed on the home tab, just click on it, just select the range and press the enter key. So it will show you the absent mark, but it will never show you the an error. Okay, it will show you the 4 subject total. Okay, clear? Now if I write here the total marks, I just insert a column, just click entire column, it will enter insert in a column. Okay, insert a column. Okay, I just type here total marks. Okay, and I just put 500. Okay, these are the total marks, and just change the cell of change marks. Okay, just wrap text, use here also wrap text, or otherwise if I use here like this. Okay, now I want to calculate the percentage equal this value. This value means this cell reference H2 divided by 500 is this cell I2. Just click on here. It will show you 0.6222. This is a general format. If you want the percentage format will come, just select the cell, go to this option and click on the percentage. It will show you the percentage 62.20. Similarly, I just put the marks of other students. Okay, like this. Just add the name also, Ravi, Ram, Ina, and Rina. Okay, I just enter the marks like this. Just fill the marks, okay. Now just take your cursor on this box. See. Just double click on it. It will show you all the marks. Okay, all the marks. All the total, right? Just double click on it. 500. And just double click on it. It will show you the percentage. If you, there are 3 ways. If either you double, just click on double click here, it will show. Otherwise, just drag and drop, or you can use the copy paste. Control C, select the rate, enter. So in this way, you can copy and paste your formula. And if you want to give the borders, just select it and give the border lines. These are the different borders. See, now I want a heading also. Just right click on it. Insert entire row. Okay, and you want to merge these cells. Select the range of the cell like this by using the mouse and click on merge in center and type here mark sheet. Suppose this is a mark sheet, I just type in mark sheet. Okay, class 9 suppose, and make it bold, increase the size like this. So in this way, you can design your mark sheet. Clear? So this is a basic formula. Okay. So I just want to tell you one more example. Like I just want to calculate the simple interest. I will take principal amount, rate, and year, time. You just say time, and I just take simple interest in short. I just take enter the values 10,000, 2%, 3 years. Now, how can you calculate the formula? What is the formula? Principal into rate into time divided by 100. So, just equal this cell reference multiply this cell reference multiply this cell reference divided by 100. It will show you the output. It will show you the simple interest 600. Okay. So in this way, you can use any other operators as well, like equal, if you want to add, plus, equal, okay? If you want to subtract, suppose we see the result, equal this cell minus this cell. Similarly, you can multiply the cell equal this cell and this cell. Sorry, equal this multiply this cell and divide equal this divide by this cell. So you have to use a cell reference always. Okay. So in this way you can calculate any value. You can means you can add, you can subtract, multiply, division. These are you can perform many